What's up, y'all? It's the Dark Horse here, reporting to y'all on another video. This is probably gonna be like a two-part video, maybe three parts. I'm trying not to make it that long, but I know it's gonna definitely be two parts. It's a lot of fuckery, a lot of things that I want to discuss in this video. Some of these things are things that I've touched on in the past. And some videos of just writings and stuff like that, and then some of it is newer content or new to some people, whatever. There's nothing new under the sun, so they say. But I'm gonna start this off by reciting my little mantra I made up. This is mine. I am God, Lord, and Master of my existence. I own all power and accountability for the quality of my reality. If I desire motion, I won't be stilled. If I desire stillness, I won't be moved. This is my power. This is my way. Left hand, dark side. Alright, come on. Burn some sage on this, because this is a real foolishness going on out here. Because I ain't burning no sage in a while. Dragon's blood incense here. Let's get it going. Alright. First thing I'm gonna go in and talk about is children. There was a incident, quite a few incidents that you hear of all the time, but one in particular comes to mind, and I don't talk too much in detail about the situation because I personally don't know the people. I just heard of the situation. It's something that happened in the area where I'm from, or where I live. Children, you got young children who, are talking about killing people, or you should go kill yourself, or killing themselves, or stuff like that, First of all, you know what? I'm gonna just say there was a situation where a child, committed suicide. A child. I mean, this kid was. It was a child, Like it doesn't matter how old it was, It was a child. It was a kid. It wasn't like, I don't even think it was a teenager, Committed suicide. How does this kid even know or understand anything about that topic, that subject, suicide? He shouldn't even have any understanding of what that is, and further, let alone actually committing it and doing it. So who has been talking to this kid about this? How does he know about suicide? Is he learning it from other children? Is he learning it from other children? Is he, learning it from his parents? But evidently this kid You know, he had some issues. He was getting bullied and stuff like that. And he killed himself. Now, and I really, really, what were the parents doing? That's the question. What were they doing? Where were they? That's, I mean, I don't even need to ask any more questions. I probably shouldn't even have to go any further into this by me just stating that. Like, that opens a whole fucking door of what, you know what I'm saying? Like, why? Why weren't the parents involved in this? You know what I'm saying? My kid, I want to know what happened at school. How was your day at school? What's your homework? Is that there's no situation by any way, shape, or form should go with a child should go unattended to. You know what I'm saying? By a parent, especially something like that. Like, there's no way that things should have gotten so bad for this kid mentally for him to want to commit suicide. Like, the parents is automatically should have been there to intervene. All of that from the first time you're being bullied. I want to know what's going on so we can take care of this. If the teachers ain't doing what they got to do to take care of this, I'm gonna teach you how to take care of yourself. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna teach you how to take care of yourself regardless, just in case the teachers don't do what they got to do. You know what I'm saying? And if there's other things that may prevent that, then we'll deal with that too. But there is no way in hell that the situation should have gotten that far to where the kid committed suicide. So, moving on. And I should have went over this stuff before I started this video, but I kind of did last night. I'm hoping everything comes to me from these notes, but bear with me. Alright. And I brought this up for a specific reason. Okay. People's intentions are more important than actions. And I was having this discussion about this with someone that I was giving a ride. I'm a driver. I drive for Uber and Lyft and stuff. But yes. And this is the order that it goes for me. Words don't hardly mean shit to me. Like, you know, I can understand in certain situations where they can mean something, but for the most part, I don't care too much what a person says about me, you know what I'm saying? And not even really so much what a person, I don't even really care what, you know, people think, but words mean very little. Actions mean something, but I know that, you know, you got a bunch of actors out here, people who are actors. They do things, but they do certain things, but their intentions are otherwise. You know what I'm saying? So what's important to me is someone's intentions. I want to know what their intentions are. Why? Why did they do something? Why do they want this? Why did they say that? You know what I'm saying? Their intentions. What do you intend on doing? And I always use this type of situation as an example, you know. Say you're in a, you know, what, you know, a monogamous relationship or whatever. Supposedly monogamous or exclusive. Dating, whatever. And this person, you know, guy or girl, they mess around. You know, they kind of break the promise that y'all made to each other, you know. Ended up dating somebody else, ended up kissing somebody else. Even worse, maybe, you know what I'm saying, had some sexual intercourse, whatever. Okay, yeah, that's you know, if y'all had an agreement, depending on how you believe in conducting your dealings with other people as far as like dating relationship goes, you know, I'm assuming most people, you know, exclusive means that y'all make a promise that y'all not gonna mess with nobody else, you know what I'm saying? Me personally, you know, I've gotten to a point in my life where, you know, I just don't have expectations like that, you know what I mean? So therefore I mean, and that doesn't mean that, you know, I myself may, commit or, you know, acts like that. I'm a person that if I give my word, I'm gonna follow through with my word. But, you know, as a protective mechanism or whatever, I don't set myself up for expecting someone to keep those promises. And not everyone's like me, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I guess in a sense, I don't get myself into situations like that, no matter what they tell me, you know what I'm saying? Like, you could tell me something all you want to. My point is this, you can tell me something all you want to. If you're doing it, you're doing it. You know what I'm saying? It shouldn't matter if I really believe you or not, you know? Like, really, like, and we don't even need to go into the discussion if whether I believe you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, I hope if that's what you say you're doing, that's what you say you're doing. Like, that's, you are giving me your word, and I can agree, like, okay, you know what I'm saying? Like, I could say that I'm not going to do this or that and a third or whatever, whatnot. But at the end of the day, it is up to you to keep that end of it. If you don't, then whatever I decide to do is what I decide to do with that. You know what I'm saying? Simple as that. I'm not going to, you know, it's kind of like, you know, I don't feel like you should be so hardwired and driven to make me believe you. You know what I'm saying? So, if you're doing it, you're doing it. Whatever. So, it's like this. That's why, you know, intentions are important. So, but say they break the promise, right? You know, you say you are a type of person like, oh, you really bent out of shape about those things. You know what I'm saying? Most people do. I've been there in the past. You know, I understand. Man, all right, look. Why? If a person, and this is with anything, if a person cannot be honest and be open about what their intentions are and why they did what they did, then you need to go ahead and leave that situation be. Because 9 times out of 10, they want to keep you in chaos, chaotic, so they can create their own agenda. You know what I'm saying? From chaos, you know, creation is, things are created from chaos, really, when you think about it. So, whenever they are, you know, if they are trying to keep a constant state of chaos, can't let things settle, you know what I'm saying, and keep things stable, and they can't be upfront and honest about their intentions, then they don't want to be, because they want to keep you confused, because the more they keep you confused, the more they can do what the hell they want to do. That's, those type of people want their cake and eat it too. So, instead of just being upfront and honest from the get-go, like, hey, you know, this is how I am, you know what I'm saying? They want you to be a certain way while they are like this, you know what I'm saying? Those are some of the worst types. But anyway, moving forward, us men, we need to especially us brothers out here, we need to invest in low profile more low profile, more off the grid type of lifestyle. Produce more and consume less. Become more self-sufficient. Become less dependent upon the structure or the system that has been established, that has been causing so much of turmoil in this world or whatever, and become more self-sufficient. Now, my idea of it is pretty extreme, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying I'm far from putting any of these things into play, but I haven't given up on it, and it's something that I'm definitely working towards in this lifetime, you know, as much as I can. Not just for myself and for my family and loved ones and stuff like that, but I mean, also for just to set an example as to the direction we need to go with this as a people, and also for someone to come along and take it a step further. You know what I'm saying? You know, to accomplish what I wasn't able to accomplish. You know, but I at least need to get things going in the right direction. So yes, invest, and what I mean by that is, and you know what's crazy? It's, you got this freaking deer zombie disease now, which is I think the actual term for it is CWD, chronic waste disease, where, like, I've always been, you know, I've always, you know, talked amongst my friends and stuff like that. You know, I actually grew up in a household who grew their own garden and stuff like that. We had our own vegetables. And I do advocate hunting, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you eating meat, you know. I'm about to start a vegetarian diet myself. You know, it's not something I'm gonna do for, like, you know, for the rest of my life, but I feel like, you know, you should change your diet like the seasons change, you know. There's, like, you should, you know, if you want to invest in, like, more of a, like, things that you could do for, like, you know, fishing, hunting, you know, invest in getting enough of land to where you can grow a garden, or you get a house, get enough of land big enough to where you can grow enough of food to feed the people in your general area, kind of like having a little community and stuff like that. Those are the type of things we need to be trying to focus on, you know, with the simple things. And I believe it, it's going to be resistance. It's already resistance. I automatically, when I seen it, I look at the deer zombie disease as resistance. I'm like, you know, most people, you know, deer is, when it comes to, like, protein and stuff like that, deer is one of the animals who have the highest content of protein in the meat. Why? Because they're getting it, they're getting so much of it from plants. They are complete, they that's all they do is they graze, they eat, you know, eat green food. So unlike a cow who's getting fed a bunch of man-made shit on the farms and stuff like that, it's gonna be a healthier quality of meat. But now somehow these deers is getting diseases from them, and what I heard was that it's because people are trying to domesticate deers, and they've been feeding them, and you fucking them up. So whoever's doing that, I'm hoping that they make a law to where they can't do that shit, because you know, it's causing the deers to have disease and stuff like that. So I hope they make a law to pass that, dude. Like, for real. Like, don't do that. You know what I mean? You're making these deers sick. They're unhuntable. That's hurting. Nobody knows how this disease affects human beings. You know what I'm saying? It says something similar to the mad cow disease. But I'm not going to harp on that too much. But, yes, we need to focus on being more self-sufficient as quickly as possible, because our options, you could clearly see, because of this deer shit, our options are becoming thinner and thinner. They fucking trying to put our backs against a wall. I'm trying to tell you, you know. So, I mean, and you're hearing this talk about they're coming up with certain policies to where you're making it hard for you to grow your own food. I haven't heard in full detail or know in full detail about that, but I've heard people talk about it before, and I'm like, I didn't really take it too seriously, because I know people growing gardens and shit, and I don't, like, that could be just some fear-mongering stuff, but, especially as men, we need to start investing in being more self-sufficient and be more producers than consumers. Consume less, produce more. Not just make more of whatever for profit, you know what I'm saying, for yourself, for your family, for your community, you know what I'm saying, to build a foundation to where you ain't got to depend on going to the grocery store all the time. You already know that a lot of the shit in the grocery store is tampered with, you know what I'm saying? A lot of stuff, sure in hell better stay away from damn, try to stay out of the fast food restaurants. I know everybody got their vices. Mine's is Rally's Fries, but ain't no way in hell am I getting a burger from a Rally's or anywhere. McDonald's, sure in hell, I don't fool McDonald's at all. None of that. You know, I cook my own burger if I want a burger or something like that. Now, I don't eat burgers often anyway. But, moving forward. Oh, man. Now, this is a really tough, touchy subject that I'm about to get on. And I know some guys gonna probably watch this, and you know, I like to talk to my people, man, like, you know, my melanated people, because we do have the bunny end of issues, should I say, today, you know what I mean? Not disregarding anybody else for their issues and stuff like that, but just like, you know, my friend has their issues, you know, my friend over here has their issues, my family, maybe some cousins or whatever, having their issues and stuff. I gotta deal with my issues first before I need to be straight first before I'm making sure everybody else, checking on everybody else, you know what I'm saying, making sure they straight. Within a reasonable means, you get what I'm saying? And I feel like black people need to focus on themselves. So that's why I talk a lot to us, specifically us. Now, if you're someone else, if you of another race and you listening to this and you feel like this can apply and use it, then fine, use it. But there is no point in, I don't like it when people do that shit. Oh, man, not just black folks, too. Like, look, man, we not going to go into this tit-for-tat comparison game about who got what bad, this, that, and the third. Like, we just not. You know what I'm saying? Like, so, the women's standards, sisters. I'm gonna try to stay cool with this one. You know what I mean? I'm gonna try to properly convey my passion about this because it gets me heated sometimes. I got some people I want to shout out because a lot of this stuff that I'm talking about was inspired by these guys. I'm gonna shout them out. Either doing me discussing this or at the end of this video. A man with structure and discipline who moves with accuracy. I'm talking about us brothers out here. And precision. And who was a problem solver. Because that's what men do. That's what we're supposed to do as men. As a man, masculine energy is to put things into order and solve problems and progress forward, move forward. It's about progression, about growth. You know what I'm saying? It seems like our sisters nowadays don't want nothing to do with guys like this. And why? Why? You get a guy who is a brother who is you know, pretty much on his shit, hitting the gym every day. Got at least got himself, his situation stable. You know what I'm saying? Like he may be working for somebody, but at the same time he's got, you know, he's got either a small business started or he's, you know what I'm saying, you know, got plans to plans for a business or whatever. But I mean he's pretty much got his situation under control. Like he's got things under control to the point to where he can provide. You know what I'm saying? He's moving right. He ain't out here on a whole bunch of foolishness. You know what I'm saying? Going to jail. Getting mad over stupid shit. Ready to go do something stupid and crazy. For a little bit of nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's smart. He's intelligent. You know what I'm saying? He's got plans. He's moving with real precision out here. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all don't want nothing to do with guys like that. Why? And I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. I got my theory as to why. A lot of y'all like to just have something to complain about. You like hearing yourself. You like the way your whiny and bitchy ass voice sound. I'm going to just be 100 with you. You know what I'm saying? You think this shit's cute. You think it's funny. Like, if that's the case, then why don't you go and be a comedian or something? You know what I'm saying? You feel like complaining about some shit is cute. Everybody want to have the worst story. And, you know, sometimes even make fun of it and shit like that. You know? You know, sometimes I've heard people, like, you know, cussing their kids out for no reason, just because they want people to know how bad and ratchet their mouth can be. Like, they think that shit's cute, man. It's just not cute, yo. You know, if that's the case, then go fucking be an actor or something, man. Go to school to be an actor, learn how to act or something. Go be a comedian or something, man. You know what I'm saying? But, like, to do it just for the fuck of doing it because you want people to fear you or be like, oh, damn, man, yo, man, damn, that girl crazy, dog. Man, yeah, boy, she ain't nothing to play with, bro. Yeah, she crazy. Just for that little bit of glory and praise by other bum-ass motherfuckers around you, huh? You want to be unruly and uncontrollable. I ain't saying you got to be controlled, but you want to be unruly and undisciplined and still and remain chaotic just for the sake of looking cute. You know what I'm saying? In front of people. You know, because you want to fulfill some sort of silly-ass image. That ain't... I mean, like I said, go try and be an actor for real then. You know what I'm saying? If that's the case, go do something with that. That's what you want to do. But we ain't got time for games. We ain't got time for actors. You know what I'm saying? So, my conclusion is this right here. It's pretty much the glorification and the desire for degradation and destruction. You know what I'm saying? You don't really want, you know, okay, for instance, I know I've said this before. The function is way more, holds way more value than the image. So, guys who move with structure, discipline, precision, they in the gym, these guys probably practicing the martial arts, they probably, you know, got business plans in place to get more money, they got a side business that's getting them extra money, they got their own shit, you know what I'm saying, they planning on building something for real, you know, I know cats who, you know, they go hunting. They go to the gun range and stuff. You know what I'm saying? They out here really trying to gain some knowledge. Knowledge is power, no matter what you're learning how to do or whatever. But the you constantly see these girls, these sisters out here picking these little poo butt simps, ain't shit ass dudes. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna say this, okay? Say you got what, six? Or is it, what was the number I went with? I decided to go with 6 or 12. Let's say six. Okay. Say you got six guys, right? And no, let's do 12. Okay, 12. 12 guys, right? You got these guys, you judge these guys off of, you know, their image. You know, who's, a lot, you hear this a lot of times, you know, we pick the bad boys, you know, little thug-ass dudes or whatever, whatnot, because simple fact, you know, we want to be, make sure we are, we're protected, you know, so I want to feel protected. So, you know, because of... You may not fuck with this guy because, you know, maybe he's, you know, short in stature or because he's light-skinned or, you know, he ain't thug enough, you know what I'm saying? He ain't a gangster, you know what I mean? Like, or because he's dark-skinned, you know what I'm saying? Maybe because he's got curly hair, you know what I mean? Or whatever. I only fuck with dudes with dreads, you know what I mean? Like, little stupid shit like that, right? Okay. You got 12 guys, right? You got guys, you got six of them who fit the image that you like, right? And you got six of them who don't fit that image. Now, out of the three, you need, out of the three, you need, Out of the six that do fit that image, it's three of them that ain't gonna be able to protect you for shit. You know what I'm saying? Don't have really had the necessary skills. And then the other three, they came just for the simple fact that they been through some shit. You know what I'm saying? This, that, and the third. Or whatever. And then out of the ones over here, you got what? You got three who, you know, actually are very capable of. They know how, well-trained, this, that, and the third, been through some experiences and stuff like that as well. But, and then you got three who, you know, they don't, you know what I'm saying? They just good guys, ain't really about that life, you know what I'm saying? You pick all of these guys over here, right? So out of 12, you only gonna have three motherfuckers that could really protect you, right? You need, say, 60% protection in order for you to be properly protected. Guess what? You falling short. So you're going to die. You know what I'm saying? Because you pick solely off of image. And that's the problem. We get so fixated on images. Us dudes do it too. You know what I'm saying? We always want to pick the... That's why we end up in the shit that we in. Because we picking the chick with a fat ass and a pretty smile. Probably got fake hair. But she dumb as fuck. You know what I'm saying? Don't ask her for advice. She can't tell you shit. Or whatever. She want to talk about acrylic nails all the time. So, the thing is this. And then with that being said, you pick these guys, you know what I'm saying? I'm not knocking nobody for their lifestyle, but I went through that stage myself. Look, we are supposed to grow though. Those tables, those labels, I said this in my last video, those labels, thugs, gangsters, you know what I'm saying, pimps, shit like that, those were not original titles of ours. We did not create that shit. The system created that. We were kings, warriors, queens, gods, lords, goddesses. That's what we were. Pharaohs. You know what I'm saying? None of this, all this gangster thug bullshit. We wasn't, that is not original. That is not original to us. You know what I'm saying? Those are things that are destroying us. Hoes and shit. You know what I mean? So, now, and I'm going to say this. Some of these thug-ass motherfuckers are simps too, man. You know what I'm saying? Just because you know, I'm tagging a new definition in it. Just because you are lame, you know what I'm saying? If you ain't got some sort of fucking intelligence about you, you got something, some substance, something deep about you, profound. If all you about is sitting up and talking about, I bust my gun, I'm smoking weed, and I'm the best in 2K, then, dog, you a lame, my nigga. For real. You a lame. You know what I'm saying? You a simp, bro. So, with that being said, if they are, you know, preferring to pick these simps and lame ass poo butt little motherfuckers over some real deal dudes, you know what I'm saying, real deal men or whatever, whatnot, then this is why they preferred, man. You know, like they can play the control games. See, the thing is about discipline. A man who's got discipline, who moves in a certain way, and he knows what he's doing, and he has competence in what he's doing, in the direction that he's heading in life. People think about discipline as a factor of being controlled. Nah, man. When you got discipline, it makes you hard to control. You can't control someone who knows what the fuck they doing. You can't manipulate them, should I say. You know what I'm saying? You can't control discipline because they're like, nah, I know what I'm, I got this. I know what I'm doing. Just chill out. You know what I'm saying? Okay, well, you do it that way. Go ahead and do it this way. This, I'm doing this way because this is how I know how it's supposed to be done. You know what I'm saying? So, and then another part of it is this. If she got some little average-ass, ain't-shit-ass dude, she knows she ain't going to have to step her game up. You know what I'm saying? She know that all she can bring, that she know that she'll be able to get away with just bringing, you know what I'm saying, a fat-ass pussy and a cute face to the table. You know what I'm saying? She know that that dumb-ass nigga ain't going to give a fuck. It, like, he's going to be cool with just that. You know what I'm saying? But a real-ass man, you're going to have to come with something else to the table besides that. So, she won't have to grow. She won't have to step her game up. It's intimidating when a dude, when you got a real ass dude who was about his shit and on his business, man. It's intimidating. So, y'all know what y'all need to do. I don't need to tell you. You know what I'm saying? I don't need to say, yo, man, step y'all. You know what I'm saying? Open your mind, make better, you know what I'm saying? Try to make better choices. Give some of these other guys a shot or some shit like that. I don't need to say that. Man, I don't even feel like I want to say that for real because, like, y'all got some internal work and some things that y'all need to handle and take care of yourselves before you even try to go fuck with one of these dudes for real because they not having it. You know what I'm saying? Like, real talk. Guys like us, we not having it. It's just not going to last long, bro. Probably won't even give you a shot. You know what I'm saying? And then on top of that, I hate to see the reverse case happen to see, you know what I'm saying, you know, even though some of us guys out here, there's some of us guys out here that, and I'm going to say this, this is for guys who may have these tendencies. If you a man and you on your shit and you heading in the right direction, but you still got a little sentiment, a little softness to you, you tend to be still a little weak to that temptation. Dude, don't let these girls get you the fuck off track, dog. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real. Dude, take it for what it is, bro. A fat ass and a pretty smile is what it is and what it is. If she a fun girl, let her stay a fun girl. Have fun with her and keep it moving, bro. I mean, I'm just saying, if that's what you about, you know what I'm saying? Like, You know, some of us guys is looking for something better than that. But if you out here and you still trying to have fun and shit, don't mistake it for something deeper than what it really is what I'm telling you. So, I'm gonna stop this right here, and we're gonna be continuing on with part two. Dark Horse out.